if you have written tutorials or written instructions for your lessons and you know that's gonna take minimum of like maybe 20 minutes before anyone could complete that lesson, then this is gonna be the one that you want to turn on because you don't want them to cheat. Hi, Danica here, and I design WordPress membership sites. In this series, we are still in the LearnDash for beginners, and in this video, we're gonna continue on the deep dive that we are doing with the display and content options that LearnDash lessons and topics offers. On the previous video, we have checked out the assignment uploads. So if you have missed that, please watch that video so that it will make sense which options is the best for your course or your setup. In this video, we're gonna go and check out the forced lesson timer. So they have some info here. It says the lesson cannot be marked as completed until the set time has elapsed. So example, if you have this written tutorials or written instructions for your lessons and you know that's gonna take like 20 minutes before anyone could like a minimum of like maybe 20 minutes before anyone could complete that lesson, then this is gonna be the one that you want to turn on because you don't want them to cheat or to skip that lesson without reading it properly or taking the time to consume that content properly. So you could set that in here. So as an example, I'm gonna just refresh this. Okay, so it's now marked as complete. So I'm just gonna uncheck that so that we could test this. Again, you could go to the back end to manually do this. Refresh. Okay. So if I turn this on, the force timer, it will give me three fields. First is the hour, minutes, and then seconds. So you need to set that in here. So if this takes like 2 hours, then you set 2 hours in here. If it takes 48 hours, you could also do that in here. So let's just test the 2 hours for now and see how that looks. Okay, so the timer has then started. So I'm gonna see exactly how or how much time I need to spend before I could mark this complete. So the mark complete is now grayed out. So you could see that in here. And you could also see that the assignment earlier is gone because again, you could only select which one you need to set. It's either video progression, assignment uploads, or forced lesson or topics timer. So I have 2 hours for that one before I could mark this complete. So this is too much, but just to give an example that whatever you need, like example, if this is a very large lesson, maybe 2 hours will make sense. But if it's just like a 30 minutes one, then you could also set 30 minutes. Now, as you can see, the timer was not reset, and that's because it already started. Like that data was already saved from my profile that I was currently taking this lesson and I only have that time left. Now to solve that, so after example, I set this, or maybe you want to change the timer to 30. That will only like take effect, like the new time that you have set, it's only gonna work for those member or enrolled user who haven't taken up this lesson yet. But for those existing one, do note that the original or the previous timer that you have set is the one that they're gonna follow. So do note on that one. So maybe what I could do is I could find a course and let's just say this one. I'm gonna try to set the lesson for this to 4st. Oops, I need to turn this off to 30 minutes. Or maybe let's just try 1 minute so that we could see how that works. Refresh. So I now have 58 seconds before I could like mark this complete. So as you can see, the mark complete button is still grayed out and I can't click it. Does nothing. So I'm gonna wait for this timer to be over so that you could see how it looks.
A few minutes later.
So now the timer is over and the button is now green and the timer is now gone. So I can now mark this complete and proceed to the next one. So that's how the timer works. Now if we preview this, remember we did originally start with this at 2 hours, so I still have 1 hour and 57 minutes before I could mark this complete. So even if I, like, as a member or enrolled user, exit to this lesson, the timer will continue to count for me, so do note on that one. So I hope this video helps. Again, if you decide to change the timer of an existing lesson, please note that new time that you've set will only work for those upcoming members that will be taking up that lesson. But for the existing one who has already started that lesson or topic, whatever the original timer that you have set is the one that they will follow. So note on that one. And yeah, if you have any question regarding forced timer for your lessons and topics in LearnDash, please comment that down below and I'll do my best to answer your question like as soon as I could. And I hope this video helps. I'll see you in the next one. Thanks for watching. Bye.